Welcome back. In this video, I'll be going through DMX with WLED. So in my previous videos, I covered MQTT, which enabled us to control the light from outside our network. DMX is something quite different altogether. If you've ever been to a nightclub or any stage show, really, which has got all the, you know, the stage lights and those sorts of things, they're all controlled by this protocol called DMX. The reason being that if you controlled each light individually and ran a cable back to your control panel, it's just not practical at all, especially when you've got hundreds of lights. So with DMX, they have one cable going between each light, which is daisy chained between them all, and you've got a control panel to control those lights. It's a lot easier. So with the WLED light, I think there's a firmware you can install which allows you to connect directly to DMX through the daisy chain, but we just want to use Wi-Fi, so we're using Wi-Fi protocols to connect using the DMX protocol. So to do that, we just need to configure the lamp itself to accept that, and also we just need some software to drive it. So I'll be going through the settings I used on my lamp and the settings I used within some software to drive the lamp. So the software I've used is called Jinx, and we'll cover that, but first we'll just have a look at the settings I've got within my lamp for the DMX control. So here's my lamp with my sync setup. So if we just go back to the original menu, so you know where we are, we've got sync interfaces. So we click on sync interfaces, and last time in my last video we were looking at MQTT, this one here, but in this one we're looking at DMX or network DMX. There's two options here, or three, but ArtNet or E131. We're using E131. I think the only difference between these two is the port number, maybe. I'm not sure. I don't know a lot about DMX, but enough to be dangerous, I guess. And all these other settings are pretty much kept the same. I'm pretty sure they're the default. So as long as you've got your settings looking like that in your WLED, you should be good to go. The next thing to do is to install the Jinx software. I'm not going to go through the installation of the Jinx software. It's just a download. I'll share a link in the comments. You just install it. One click and it installs, right? Just like anything else. And then we're set up and up and running, and it doesn't look like much at the moment, but once we've got the lights running, we've got all these presets and bits and pieces, so you can see these squares. You can consider one of those squares one of our lights. So we've got 1 pixel here, we've got 30 in the row. You can consider one of those squares as one of those lights, and that's what it's trying to control. So for my setup, I'm only going to have 12 of those lamps going around my trampoline, and it's 30 LEDs up, so it's going to be 30 by 12. So I need to go into our setup and configure the light so Jinx software knows which LED it's talking to. So for setup, we pretty much just work from the top down, and we go to our matrix options. And like I said, I'm going to have a width of 12. So 12 lamps around the trampoline and a height of 30. So 30 LEDs in total. And okay. So that should change our layout straight away. So now we've got 12 by 30. Next thing we do is configure the output device. I've only got one going at the moment. I'll get some more going hopefully in the next couple of days. And it is set up here. We choose our protocol. I haven't tried, maybe ArtNet still works, I'm not sure. E131. I want to connect directly to this light. I don't want it to broadcast, so I know the IP address of this light already. And I've got 30 LEDs with 3 LEDs each, so I've got 90 channels in total. So that's our light configured and ready to go, right? I tried the scan button, it doesn't find it. You just have to set it up manually. So we've done our matrix, we've done our output, and now we've got to do our output patch. So you can consider again each one of these squares as one pixel on there, one light. And over here we've got the channels, and we're using red, green, and blue. So channel 0 will be red for the first light, channel 1 will be green, and channel red. The red channel will be 0, the green channel will be 1 because we start with 0, 0 is a number, and blue will be 2. For the next light down, it'll be 3, 4, 5, and so on. So rather than going through and typing them all manually, there's a fast patch button here, so we click on fast patch, and we want to start from the bottom left with RGB, and we've only got one light configured, so we just leave it as is. If there was the next lamp across, we'd obviously choose the next row across. And okay, so if we look at these lights now, it starts with 012, 345, and so on, all the way to the top. Close. Once that's configured, we just go to setup and start output. And our lamp starts coinciding with what's on the screen. So we've got other options here, like plasma, which was it? Scrolling text, not that's going to help us much. And we can also just go simple color, solid, and it'll bring up the sliders, and we can turn them all up and down. To match. So we're all go, so we can probably rotate that one as well. So it goes upwards. Cool. So that's configuring your WLED for DMX. There's other software you can use. I haven't managed to get it working, like Madrix, but they're probably all sort of compatible in some sense. But Jinx is obviously free, and it can start working pretty quickly. So give that one a go, and thanks for watching.